price of tobacco just seems to keep...
Gentlemen.
Hello.
Nice to see some friendly faces around here. Good to see Manners ain't dead yet.
Mm-hmm.
You enjoy the rest of your day.
See you soon.
Hey, folks.
Good morning to you, sir.
We've had quite enough of your kind here.
Good day so far? Anyway, take care, folks.
So long.
I hope you're doing well there, miss.
Thank you very much.
You be well and happy now.
Bye.
Okay, then.
So, there we are.
Hey, mister.
Morning, sir.
I imagine you got your work cut out for you around here. So, please, don't let me keep you.
Goodbye.
Good day to you. We'll be here if you change your mind.
Hello, sir.
How y'all doing?
Hey, out of the way. I'm on a tight schedule.
Hello, sir.
Yeah?
You must be pretty fast with that gun. You know what? I'm feeling good today.
That's good.
Anyway, sorry, you don't need to know this.
I'll see you soon.
Ah, you're back. Have a look. All for sale, except the floorboards.
Don't expect anything else from this shithole.
Come on, move already. Talk in town whispering about that boy, whoever the hell he is. Something shameful, right?
Just like last month.
Done.
Thanks, partner.
What do you think?
Hello, mister.
Ass.
Hello.
Hey, mister.
Well, hello there.
You must like living here.
Well, sure.
Come on, follow me.
You're a good boy. That's my boy.
Okay there, boy?
Boy.
can I do for you?
Okay, there. You okay?
Hey, Fenton!
Oh, never again. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Sure, Arthur.
I met a woman in town. She was talking about voting. Women voting.
They'll never allow that.
Why not? Because if we can vote, then folk, and by folk I mean men, will have to hear about how awful we got it.
We have it awful?
Sure.
How so?
All they'll let us do is teach children, clean houses, and line our backs for money. Much in the way of living. Even fancy women look sour. They'll beat us, enslave us, and punish us if we try to stand up to them.
Oh, where have you been, big man?
Out and about, you know.
I missed you, son. You find anything interesting?
It's strange country out there.
That it is.
Guess it ain't no use talking about stuff will never happen.
Hey there.
Hey.
You managing not to kill Pearson?
Only just.
Hey, Jack.
How do you?
That looks fun.
I guess.
Well, don't let me interrupt you.
Bye-bye. That's what I like to hear.
You okay, boy? You awake?
You want to sit, Mr. Morgan?
When are you gonna get your act together?
I'm just minding my own business here.
Can't go on like this.
Yes.
John.
Join the party here, Morgan.
Leave some drink for the rest of us.
Cheers to you too, English.
It ain't really? Just for you.
Okay, Morgan.
What are you doing?
Prepping for a robbery. I've had a good run of luck recently.
Okay.
Robbed a house up in Roanoke Ridge. Robbed a couple of drunken soldiers out near the swamps.
And what are you about to do?
A stage.
Well, good luck.
Well, do you want to come with me? Now, I was going to ask Sean, but he's too much of a hothead.
What's the opportunity?
A bank stage, and without much security. This feller was telling me about it a couple of nights ago when we was drinking. It's going to be coming right through, and the bank reckons the cost of security ain't worth the risk. Now, there'll be a couple guys, but nothing too serious, and lots of money. Easy money.
Well, that's always the dream of every thief. Easy money.
Well, like I was saying, my luck is in now, Arthur.
Well, then, why not? Who you taking?
I think we need a girl. See, I got a plan in mind.
Well, in that case, Tilly, You free? We got some work.
Sure. What kind of work?
Stagecoach.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
All right, come on. Let's mount up.
Good for you.
Okay, follow me. There's a good spot where we should be able to cut it off northwest of Dewberry Creek.
And you're certain this information's sound, Bill? After that mess with the Cornwall stage, I want to make sure we're not riding into another army of guards.
Yes, I'm certain.
So what's the plan?
I was thinking a little womanly distraction.
I figured that much. But what's the story? Route, number of guards, you know, important details?
Just do exactly what I say and you'll be fine, all right?
How about we do exactly what Tilly says? I'd feel a lot safer.
Because I've done all the groundwork on this. Next time she brings in a lead of her own, we'll all bow down, I promise.
I'll remember you said that.
You follow orders, you stay alive. That's what they used to tell me in the army.
That kicked you out of the army.
They did not.
I beg to differ, Marion.
Have you been going through my things?
You shouldn't have left it out.
Can you believe this, Morgan? I don't trust her any more than I trust that Kieran boy. I never have. Running with them foreman boys all them years. She could turn on us any minute.
Just shut your mouth or I'll shut it for you. You have no damn clue.
All right, just take it easy, you two. Get your minds on what matters so we do this right.
Let's cut up through the creek.
This was the spot we first picked out for a camp.
A dry riverbed?
Yep.
Who the hell suggested that?
Micah, I believe.
Well, that don't surprise me. Okay, here we are. All right, so the stage should be coming from over there.
What you want me to do?
Just act dumb and silly and get the thing stopped. You know, like you do.
And what you mean by that?
Oh, come on, don't get all precious and stuck up on me now.
I don't like your manners, Mr. Williamson. In fact, I think you're an obnoxious idiot.
What'd you say to me?
I didn't say enough to you, you useless half-man.
Half-man? Half-man, what does that even mean?
Will you two stop arguing?
He started it.
Here's a goddamn stagecoach. We doing this?
Yes. Come on, both of you, follow me! There's been a change of plan!
Yes, you act dumb and get them to stop.
Now! God damn it! It's locked. I'm gonna blow it open. Stand back. We made a right mess of that.
We stopped it, didn't we?
Yeah, after chasing it all over New Hanover, with God knows who watching. Got it. Right. Let's split up, get the hell out of here.
Okay, but you owe me my cut. Don't think I'll forget.
I know. Go on.
I'll see you back at camp.
Time to go, boy. Yeah. It'll take more than that, boy.
We survived another day.
Just about.
Guess we did.
Hey.
Why don't you sit a while?
You going out hunting again soon?
Maybe.
Well, you let me know. Might join you.
All right.
Evening.
Why don't you sit a while, Arthur?
Everything okay?
Always.
Just checking.
Sure, Arthur.
There he is.
Oh, hello.
Thank you for all your work.
Of course, Mr. Morgan.
I mean that.
I should do some work.
Everyone's favorite uncle. What you got going on?
Nothing much.
Yeah, that don't surprise me.
All right, then.
You okay?
Oh, hello.
You all right there?
Yeah. I think so.
Maka?
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you or me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little. Pearson! Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch. You tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town. And things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a cornered tiger. Anyway, somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Combe O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch. Do what has to be done, but don't fight wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parley? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap, you shoot a lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance we gotta take.
I killed Combs' brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I loved dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
Fine.
Mount up then, Morgan. Let's go then.
You know, I've been fighting Combs for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
And you're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Well, maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. Oh. What did you say? We had Pinkertons coming after us?
Because of Blackwater.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll?
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look, you ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover us, hmm?
Okay. Just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I. Hey, up there. Men on the ridge.
O'Driscoll's, from the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big. Caring too much. That's my problem.
Caring too much? There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Combs O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all, that might be nonsense too, but it's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
All right, cowpoke. You're gonna peel off up ahead. We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot just above us where you can keep an eye on things.
All right, all right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Hello, Dutch. It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing?
They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world. Hmm? How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader.
A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us. Whole heap of trouble.
They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here? Go home. Is this thing over?
Hello, sugar. You ain't dead, is you? Not...
I don't know. Colin's got a sense.
Handing him over to the law. I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella, Colin's right. We can draw them all back.
He's escaping. Shoot him. Relax. Relax. I got him.
Did I kill you?
Not yet.
No, of course not. Not yet.
But I will.
Finally! Put his weapons over there!
Arthur Morgan. It's good to see you.
Hello, Colm.
How's the wound?
I hardly feel it.
You will. Septic. It ain't nice. Now, tell me. Fine gun like you.
Why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Colm.
No, no. It's Dutch's famous cars. You killed a whole bunch of my boys.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached truth.
Let me go, Colm, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it, they get him, they forget about me.
They ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. But see, we lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
So you only met with him to grab me?
Of course. He's gonna be so mad. He's gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Oh, Arthur. Arthur, I missed you.
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
My dear boy, what?
They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help. Reverend Swanson.
He was gonna set the law on us.
No, of course he was.
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan, you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur.
Okay. I got you.
You're safe now.
That's pretty intense. Yeah. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, River.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
You can help by leaving me alone so I can actually think for once.
How are you today, Arthur?
You bastard.
Who's there?
Dutch Vanderland.
How you feeling?
Better. Good enough. You'll work it out, Dutch. You always do.
Arthur.
Hope you're working on a plan there.
Always.
Now, second thoughts, I hope you ain't working on any kind of plan at all.
When are you going to remove that chip from your shoulder?
All right, simmer down.
Yeah, very amusing.
You join us here, Morgan?
Pearson? Gentlemen?
Good to see you.
How are you?
Hey, Charles.
Good to see you back on your feet.
No rest for the wicked. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Bye, Arthur.
Hey, look who it is. Little Shawnee O'Screwloose.
Just leave it out, will you?
Why don't you tell us another story about your old Da?
What is wrong with you?
We always love to hear them.
You do what you want.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay.
We got that thing done for the Braithwaites. Better be some money at the end of this.
Oh, there will be.
I sure hope so. Well, I should get back to it.
Thanks.
Hey, Lenny. How's it going?
Good. How you feeling?
Much better. Look at you.
Oh, shut up.
Toughest flower in the bunch.
What are you trying to do here?
Well, we both know underneath you're yellow
as hell. I'm done with this now.
You are the creepiest man I know.
You wait.
Better days.
How are you, Tilly?
It all happens for a reason.
How are you, more to the point? Feeling better?
Anyway, I won't disturb you.
All right, Arthur.
Hey there.
Arthur?
So, you ain't bored of this place yet?
I guess not.
Okay.
Hey.
It's either reading or robbing with you, ain't it?
A fella can do both.
Anyway, don't let me disturb you.
Okay, Arthur.
How's it going?
I've been better.
I know the feeling.
Get away from me.
Hey, Micah.
You're alive. Good. That was some business, all right.
We are never falling for something that dumb again. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Whatever you say.
Hey.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Bet you never thought you'd end up here, huh?
I didn't know where I'd end up.
Finest whittler in all Ireland.
Morning, Arthur.
One more time, just for luck.
Yes,
What?
Take it easy. I ain't serious.
Yeah.
All right. Don't work too hard.
I work smart.
Oh, you do, do you?
Sure, Morgan.
Morning, Arthur.
Not you again. Nervy little feller, ain't you?
Wouldn't you be?
Hey, Abigail.
How are you feeling?
I'll live. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay.
Ladies?
Morning, Arthur.
You seem to have everything well in order here.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far.
Looks like hard work.
Oh, not really.
All right, well, I'll leave you to it.
Sounds good.
Well, looks like we'll live to see at least a few more days. Folks are happy, Arthur.
Happy?
Well, they're fed, which is the next best thing.
You two, come over here. Come over here.
Listen to this passage. It is beautiful.
Well, who is it, Dutch?
It's Mr. Miller, of course. An essay on the allegory of impotence. So, the question the seeker of allegorical potency should ask himself, or indeed herself, if potency is not itself too masculine a concern for our sisters to be concerned with, is this. Is it in the seeking that we find, or in the finding that we seek? While this might seem a pathway towards insanity, it is an important distinction, and also a clear one. He who finds things is wise, but he who continues to seek is ever more free. Ever more free. Isn't that the most wonderful idea of all?
Well, I guess it is quite pretty.
Pretty. It's magnificent, my dear, magnificent. Ever more free. That's us. If we keep seeking, we will find freedom. Now, you two better get back to work. Go on. What do you think, Arthur?
I don't think too much, Dutch. Not about that kind of crap, anyway.